So my motivation for MBA was purely out of interest. I'm an MBBS grad, you know, by profession. So it is a very rare thing for a doctor to move out from medicine and go into management. But what happened in my case was during my undergrad days, I was part of a lot of team building skills. Like for example, I was the GenSec of my college. I was heading one of the biggest medical conferences organized by an undergrad college. So while doing all of this, I realized that I really loved managing people. I had a certain knack for taking decisions, for solving critical issues and, you know, all of those problems. And when I researched more about it, I realized that this is the field that I would want to make a career in. And that's how I realized that, you know, MBA is my calling. GDPR preparations, so it's very important that you're well read. What I ensured was that I was reading the newspaper every day. One app that certainly helped me was Napoli, because apart from telling you what's going on around the world, it gave you a complete gist of why it happened, where it happened, when it happened and how it happened. So that is something that really helped me increase my knowledge. And why this is important is because when the topics in your group discussions are something that is known to everyone, people are well read. So if you want to stay ahead of competition, you need to have certain facts and figures, you know, so that you can put your opposition off guard, you know, in a way impress the panelists that I have more knowledge and here, you know, I have formed an opinion over the readings throughout the past time. I had joined a coaching institute, so I would say that it is a very good option if you can join a coaching institute, because they conduct mock GDs and you are normally sitting with people who have calls from the top B schools. For instance, I am studying with four other people who were there with me during the mock preparation. I did not know them personally, but we met during our preparation in the coaching institutes, and that immensely helped us because we got to know the points from other people, from others' perspectives, and that helps you form opinions and present your points in a better way when it comes to the actual GDs. My GD topic in MDI was about the demographic dividend of India. So as I mentioned, the importance of mock GDs, this was one of the first topics that we had discussed in a mock GD. So that wasn't really a big challenge for me because I already had the points in place, I had my opinions formed, and so that was a bit easier for me to crack. When it came to personal interview, your PI basically revolves around who you are as a person, what kind of personality you have, because try and understand one thing, all of the call getters who are there are all top rank holders when it comes to the CAT. What institutes are looking for is your personality, your communication skills, whether you're a cultural fit for their college and for companies in future. So they check all these skills to ascertain whether you are a manager, whether you can go and fit into a top corporate company, because eventually that's going to build their brand name for the college. So it's important that you have a story around which your life has gone through. So say A thing happened that inspired me to do a B thing, and once B thing happened, I realized certain characteristics in my personality which have prepared me to think of MBA as a future. You cannot go and say stuff like, you know, I want a fat paying job, I want a big salary job, or I want to become the CEO of a company directly. You need to have certain goals and a certain vision where you want to be at the end of it, and that is what impresses your interviewers. Apart from that, another important thing is, as I mentioned earlier, that you're well-read, because there'll be a lot of questions asked about the happenings around the world. They want to test how abreast you are about the general happenings of the world, you know, be it, so elections is a hot topic that's coming in right now. So certain policy changes, what are the governments doing with respect to that, how is it going to affect the corporate culture. So all of these things, you just need to be abreast about that and be well-prepared. And finally, it's about how you present yourself. You, with all the knowledge that you have, if you're not presenting it in a good way, if you're not happy, if you're not smiling, well, that has a major impact. So be relaxed, be happy, and just come and enjoy the process, because eventually it's an experience worth learning. So when it comes to PI, there are two aspects that you need to keep in mind. One is that you have to be thorough about whatever is mentioned on your CV, and the second is you have to be abreast with all the political happenings or the general happenings around the world. You know, for instance, I was asked about a coalition that had happened on the very day I had my interview on. So that is something I did not know because I had not read the news that morning. But apart from that, what they try to do is they try to question you on the things you mention on your CV. You know, for example, I had mentioned I do a lot of extracurriculars, I'm into sports. So they asked me, what is the diameter of a basketball ring? What is the height of the post that is there in a professional game for basketball? So these are the things that they do to throw you off guard. You know, these are like stress interviews. What they're trying to tap from here is, how do you handle stress? How do you handle things in a situation where you probably do not know the answer? And if you have a smiling face, if you're confident about whatever you say, and you can come up with a logical answer to it, well, they're more than happy, you know, with the answer that you give. So that is my advice, that just prepare well, be well-read, and ensure that you know everything that's on your CV inside out.